Inner Traditions Audio presents Psychedelic Wisdom, The Astonishing Rewards of Mind-Altering Substances by Dr. Richard Lewis Miller, read by Brock Blatter. Foreword: The Wisdom of Psychedelic Elders, Rick Doblin. Psychedelic Wisdom is being published at a time when humanity is generating more knowledge than ever before in human history, but has a critical need for wisdom of any kind. In 1959, several years before he died, Carl Jung said, quote, "We need more psychology. We need more understanding of human nature, because the only real danger that exists is man himself. He is the great danger, and we are pitifully unaware of it. We know nothing of man, far too little. His psyche should be studied, because we are the origin of all coming evil." Unquote. Psychedelic Wisdom is a courageous response to Jung's call to study the psyche to better understand, address, and reduce the evil that humans can cause. Psychedelic Wisdom is composed of Dr. Richard Lewis Miller's incisive and psychologically probing interviews of the personal psychedelic explorations and the lessons learned of an expertly curated group of psychedelic elders, scientists, doctors, therapists, activists, and teachers. A common theme in the interviews is the role that psychedelics played in enabling people to go beyond their individual egos to an experience of interconnectedness, and of the personal and political implications of that realization of that interconnectedness. Other themes that emerge in the interviews are the use of psychedelics to work through personal trauma, conflicts with others, the search for love, purpose, and meaning, and other earthbound challenges. The virtue of Dr. Miller's decision to interview psychedelic elders is that the interviewees have had decades to ponder the consequences of their psychedelic experiences, which for most everyone interviewed started early in their lives. During the recent psychedelic renaissance that has taken half a century to develop, following the backlash to the psychedelic counterculture and research in the 1960s, Psychedelic Wisdom facilitates acknowledgement of the stories of these interviewees about their own psychedelic experiences. As an example of the power of personal stories, voter opinion surveys of U.S. citizens who voted to legalize marijuana in state ballot initiatives indicated that a primary motivation came from knowing a medical marijuana patient who had revealed to them the beneficial effects of their own use. There's enormous social change potential in open, honest, psychedelic stories in this book and elsewhere, especially in interpersonal conversations and old-fashioned word of mouth. Another theme that emerges in the interviews relates to the evil that comes from people thinking in terms of us versus them. This mindset is inherent to humans. We identify ourselves as part of various kinds of groups based on tribe, race, nationality, religion, gender, sexual orientation, class, and so on, with some people inside your group and some people outside your group. While tribe or group identification is important and useful and is not itself inherently a problem, people too often devalue and even dehumanize those who are outside of their group. In the extreme, this can lead to economic exploitation, slavery, rape, murder, and genocide. In contrast to this othering, the unitive mystical experiences that are frequently generated by the classic psychedelics can provide experiential confirmation of our essential commonality with all other people, indeed, with all other life on our planet, regardless of the ways we identify and divide ourselves. Many of the interview subjects mention these experiences and the profound impact they made on their lives. These unitive, mystical experiences can potentially, but not in all situations, induce identification with and compassion for people who are different from us in some ways. Nevertheless, culture and context are more determinative of attitude and behavior changes flowing from unitive mystical experiences than those experiences in and of themselves. One example is the patriarchal and homophobic attitudes of some South American syncretic ayahuasca churches who, in their struggle to survive, have blended with the Catholic Church and its views. The power of context and culture to shape psychedelic experiences is a key aspect of psychedelic-assisted therapy, in which a supportive therapeutic alliance is an integral component of the healing process. In 1983, Robert Mueller, Assistant Secretary General of the United Nations, wrote in New Genesis, Shaping a Global Spirituality, that the unitive mystical experience was an antidote to fundamentalism. The cover of Mueller's book featured a picture of Earth from space. This is an example of overview effect, which, according to Wikipedia, is, quote, a cognitive shift in awareness reported by some astronauts during spaceflight, often while viewing Earth from outer space. It is the experience of seeing firsthand the reality of Earth in space, which is immediately understood to be a tiny, fragile ball of life, hanging in the void, shielded and nourished by a paper-thin atmosphere. The effect may also invoke a sense of transcendence and connection with humanity as a whole, from which national borders appear petty. Unquote. This sense of our collective nature can, in the extreme, also become dangerous. We're living in a time of tension, with authoritarian governments emphasizing the collective over the individual, with individual human rights under attack and being trampled around the world, and with democracy itself threatened in the United States, the cradle of modern democracy. The prioritization of individual freedom, taken to an extreme, can also be dangerous in ways that undermine collective action and shared responsibilities. For example, in responding to the COVID-19 pandemic, income inequality, and global climate change. Psychologist Abraham Maslow, one of the founders of humanistic psychology, in his widely taught Hierarchy of Human Needs, is commonly understood to have placed the highest need as self-actualization, the drive to find and develop one's own uniquely individual nature. In a way, self-actualization is a libertarian ideal focusing on the primacy of the individual over the collective. What is not widely taught is that Maslow's view of human needs evolved in the last few years of his life as he studied non-ordinary states of consciousness and mystical unitive experiences, and as he engaged in dialogues with psychedelic researchers such as Dr. Stanislav Grof. Maslow's final articulation of the hierarchy of human needs displaced self-actualization as the highest need and placed above it the need for self-transcendence, emphasizing acting for the common good from the understanding of the collective nature of our existence. What Maslow's later insight points to is that the more we understand and act in light of our collective nature, the more we can develop a path to a fuller self-actualization. The wisdom that can be generated by psychedelic experiences, discussed in many of these interviews, is that there is no inherent conflict between individual self-actualization and self-transcendence that comes from seeing ourselves as part of a larger whole. We can better appreciate differences rather than being frightened by them when we understand the depths of our commonality. Maslow's transition from self-actualization to self-transcendence suggests that we don't need to subsume our individual self into the collective, nor lose our sense of our collective nature in unbridled individualism. On a personal note, Richard Miller has been an inspiration to me as I was building MAPS, the Multidisciplinary Association for Psychedelic Studies. So it is with great satisfaction that I can pay my respects to him by writing this foreword. Richard accompanied me and other MAPS staff to Israel about 2 decades ago, when we were working to obtain permission from the Israeli Ministry of Health and the Israeli Anti-Drug Authority to start research in Israel into MDMA-assisted therapy for PTSD. I've never been known for my fashion sense, but Richard dressed elegantly for our meetings and conveyed a sense of respectability, dignity, and wisdom that helped persuade the Israeli regulators to permit us to go forward. Back in the United States, Richard hosted fundraisers for MAPS at his home that were critical to our progress in the early stages of our research. Now, all these years later, MAPS has successfully completed 1 phase 3 study into MDMA-assisted psychotherapy for PTSD, with results published in Nature Medicine in May 2021. The journal Science ranked that publication as one of the world's top 10 scientific breakthroughs of 2021. MAPS will complete our 2nd phase 3 study before the end of 2022. If those results are positive, we anticipate regulatory approval before the end of 2023 from the FDA, the Israeli Ministry of Health, and Health Canada for the prescription use of MDMA-assisted therapy for PTSD by trained therapists. We anticipate regulatory approval in England and Europe a year or so afterward, then over time in the rest of the world. As psychedelic therapy moves increasingly into the mainstream and other forms of exploration become legally available.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.